Good point. أحسنت. Number one, number one. الأمر 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 الأول. The first issue is that إقامة الحجة والبراهين. Establish the proof and evidence first. لعله لا يعرف. لعله لا يدري. لعله سمع الناس يقولون كذا فقال. Perhaps that he heard the people saying barki so and so, barki so and so, and he was saying it. Meaning by so and so, by so and so, and he said he was saying it. Like you find this kid, subhanallah, maybe like 10 years old, went to a household and everybody was swearing by Ahmed Bamba. He went back to his parents and he started swearing by Ahmed Bamba. And his parents are not even from that tariqah, he's from the other tariqah. Right? He just heard the people saying it. He didn't even know what is the meaning of this. So أول شيء, and this is important, أيها الإخوة, لا بد بالفهم. It is important, it's a very important point for us to understand this point that we keep on drilling, inshallah. أول شيء, إقامة الحجة والبراهين. Establishing the proofs and evidence. Number one, as the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم say, من كان يحلف فليحلف بالله. That's a text. Whoever swear, let him swear by Allah. Whoever swear, let him swear by Allah. Now let him understand this. And then, if he still have some obstacle of understanding those texts, well, I seen the Imam of the Masjid, he was swearing by Al-Haji this, or he was swearing by Al-Hajja this, or he was swearing by this, or he was swearing by that. Now he has obstacles. Now we're going to remove those obstacles. As a statement of Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, I would rather lie and swear by Allah than speaking the truth and swearing by other than Allah. Fahimtum? He said, I'd rather tell a lie and swear by Allah rather than swearing by other than Allah while speaking the truth. Fahimtum? Anafamu? Rather, I would rather swear by Allah and lying rather than swearing by other than Allah and telling the truth. Now why?
So which one is it better?
Huh? That's what I'm asking right now. Which one is better?
Swear.
La. Think first. Please think first. Abba Ahmed. Think first. Please. Don't just rump. Rush. Think first. Buba, which one is better?
Tell lies and swear by Allah.
I'm saying why? Why? Okay, that's what he say. That's what he say. I'm saying limadha, why is it better?
Because that's out of sick.
Okay. I agree with that. Barakallahu fikum. 95% of the answer. But you only deal with one end though. That's the other end that you got to clarify. So how about the other one? Right? Okay, how about the other one? It's just it's easy. Just look at these two things. Lying, sins, and shirk. Look at that. Sins and shirk. Look at that. Look at which one is lighter. Khalas. Between sins and shirk, which one is lighter? Ayyinhuma ayyin minhuma akhaf. Which one is lighter? Without a doubt. So this is why he said what he said. That swearing by Allah and telling a lie, this is what? This is a sin. Rather than speaking the truth and swearing by other than Allah. شرك. طيب as the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم he mentioned that whoever swear by other than Allah he has what? Kufr or polytheism. But here barakallahu fikum, what we understand from that is that it is kufrun duna kufr, but it could lead to the kufr that will take the individual out. Yes, kufr al-akbar. So therefore al-kufr yanqasim ila qismayn. Al-kufr yanqasim ila qismayn. There is two types of kufr. Kufr al-akbar and kufr al-asghar. Can we find kufr al-akbar in a Muslim? Can we find kufr al-akbar in a Muslim? Ibn, can we find kufr al-akbar in a Muslim? Baka yako? Kufr al-akbar in a Muslim? Kufr al-akbar in a Muslim?
Yes.
How yes? A Muslim.
Yes.
If a person does a kufr al-akbar, technically this is taking him out of Islam?
Yes.
That's what I'm saying. Then you cannot find it. That's very good. But can you find kufr al-asghar in a Muslim?
Yes.
If a person, we say, can you find if a person does an act of kufr? Tayyip. Now that action, take him out of Islam. That action itself, not that he is out of Islam, but that action barakah is an act of kufr. That is the action that will take, in normal condition, the individual out of Islam. But you can find kufr asghar in an individual. Mathalan, the individual, he go to the he just because of he wanna have more money, suing the individual. So he's going to the kuffar court, not believing that the Sharia of Islam is equal or lesser than the court system. He doesn't believe that. He believes that the Sharia is better. It's not even comparable. But he just was greedy. Atama. He was just greedy. He could say, okay, if I take this guy to court, I'll have more money. But if we go to the masjid and, you know, or call the scholars, you know, I might just have maybe, you know, few amount of money. But if we take him to court, then I can have more money. So it is possible that you find a Muslim having an action of kufr al-asghar. Tayyip. So he mentioned when nifaq yanqasim ila nifaq al-akbar wa nifaq al-asghar. That also hypocrisy is of two types. Hypocrisy in the major hypocrisy and the hypocrisy that is what? That is the minor hypocrisy. When we deal with the major hypocrisy, this is barakallahu fikum i'tiqadi. But when we deal with the nifaq al-asghar, this is amali. This is from the action. Na'am Aba Ismail.
Do we find in kufr al-akbar in the Muslim, like the example, it's Muslim, but it's slaughtered other than Allah, but we don't know.
Can we say, if a person slaughter for other than Allah, he's a disbeliever?
No.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. This is a qa'idah. من ذبح لغير الله فقد أشرك. From the hadith of Ali, whoever slaughter for other than Allah has disbelieved.
Yes.
Right? Hadith sarih. But now the thing about it is like, على الأعيان, على الأشخاص. Right? Let's say hey you, Fulan, right? So and so, you are a disbeliever. Why? Because you slaughter for the jinn. You can't say that. But you can say mutlaqan, if a person slaughter for other than Allah, he's a disbelief. Right? Whoever slaughter for other than Allah is a disbelief. This is clear. Tayyip. So a person, a Muslim, is the one, barakallahu fikum, that is free from shirk. Because when the person does shirk, لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ بَلِ اللَّهَ فَاعْبُدُ. بل الله, only Allah. فعبد, worship him alone. وكن من الشاكرين, and be among those who are grateful to Allah. So therefore, أيها الإخوة, yes, it is possible that you find كفر الأصغر in a Muslim. But مطلقا, whoever swore for other than Allah, he has disbelief. But now, as to say that so and so, hey you, and he gave a name, مثلا he gave what name? Hey you, fulan, let's just say fulan. Hey you, fulan, you are a kafir. Why? Because you swore for the jinn. You cannot say that. You gotta say, hey, you know what, fulan? This action that you do is an act of disbelief. Even you see him, you say, hey, fulan, this action that you do it is an act of disbelief. Allah say, the Prophet say. Allah say, the Prophet say. The Messenger say, and this is how the ulama detailed it. Now, if he persists and say, you know what, man, I don't believe this. If he say, well, I don't believe this, then barakallahu fikum, this is clear. This is very clear. When he invites you, you don't go. When he slaughter, you don't eat. If you gave him your daughter, you will take it back. If he was, yani, what else? Whatever the mu'amala that is permissible, even that are permissible, barakallahu, with the kuffar asli, will not be permissible with him no more. So the Shafi'ah Allah Ta'ala, he said, وَالشِّرْكُ, and polytheism, يَنْقَسِمْ إِلَىٰ شِرْكُ الْأَكْبَرُ وَشِرْكُ الْأَصْغَرُ. So likewise, polytheism is divided into two, the minor one and the major one. نعم. خلاصة.
A Muslim, okay.
10, 20.
A Muslim who mingles with a male, meaning female, actually, actually, like mingling with the females.
Yeah, you can say that because this is not found in the asl of the sharia that men and women will do that. But you find it in the custom of the kuffar to do that. 10:20. I'm so sorry. This is my mistake. Forgive me, please. Forgive me. Forgive me. Forgive me. 10:20. Ismahuni wallah. Oh man, I'm giving you this cup, Abdullah. 10:20, I didn't even look at the time, man.
أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي لا سلام حي لا الفلاح